In this video, we're going to take a look at how you can use MacFun's Luminar to do some color grading and color correction. Hi, my name is William Beem, and you can find me at williambeem.com. Today, we're going to take a look at a couple of photos inside of Luminar, and I just wanted to show you some of the tools and filters that are available for you, so you can correct your photos, color, or you can do some enhancements to give it a bit more of an artistic look. Over here on the side, you can see where we've got our panel. We've got our layers, and pay attention to blend mode, because we're going to be changing this from time to time. And also, we've got our filters. I kind of like to keep my workspace clean and add the filters that I want. The first one we're going to go through is a very basic one, and that is going to be color temperature. Think of this similar to the white balance that you've seen on some of the other programs. So this one, I'm going to leave my blend mode normal. I'm just going to grab the eyedropper, and we're looking for kind of a neutral gray. And I think right about here. So let me bring up kind of our before and after split screen look. And you can see right off the bat, we've got a very noticeable change. You can tell from the white top that she's got on over here, there was a little bit of a bluish tint on that. And then on this side, it looks better. You can tell her skin tone is definitely much more alive. So that is kind of the very first simple thing you would want to do, is check your color temperature to see if it's the way you want. Now, just because you get an accurate color temperature doesn't necessarily it's artistically the way you want it. There are times that you may want to go for something that's a bit moodier. You know, let's just be absurd and drag this all the way over here. If you're looking for kind of a nighttime look or something that's chilling, you may want to drag your temperature way down. So you've got some options here, but using this little eyedropper is a good way to get a white balance that you can trust and add some color back in and get rid of that. The next one that we're going to look at is going to be the channel mixer. This one separates your channels red, green, blue, and of course the opposite of each one. So on the other side of blue, you're going to have yellow. On the other side of green, you're going to have magenta. The other side of red, you're going to have cyan. And you notice that on the red channel, obviously we've got our reds already mixed up here. The question we're asking with the channel mixer is, what do you want to add into the red? So particularly pay attention to our lipstick here, and we're going to make some very strange changes. Let's see, if I pull the greens all the way over here, you can see how that's affecting our skin. If I push it all the way up, then we've kind of gone in the opposite direction. Some of these changes are going to be garish. What I would recommend is that you make very, very subtle changes. So you may want to enhance the red a little bit. Depending on what you need, you may want to pull it all the way back and get the opposite color. So we're going to put this one back up here about 45 or 50. And let's say that for this one, I want to also toss in, maybe I'll do that a little bit more. I'm going to go and check my blue channel and pull it back a little bit. So if I do the opposite here with blue and I kind of push up a little bit on that, you can see that that's going to turn around and add some of the yellow. So the blue will be more towards this end, the yellow will be more to that end. And we've made a noticeable change in there. It's definitely going to give her a sharper appearance. Keep in mind, we go back and pull this off. So that is our before, and this is our after. The next one I want to look at is the channel mixer. What you're going to find with some of these filters are they act on different aspects of your photograph. Some will work in shadows, midtones, and highlights. Some will work on color channels, like as this one does. So you've got your red in here. If you want to obviously move this up a little this way, you're going to get a bit more red into it. Now, what this one is allowing you to do is to add other colors or subtract other colors from that red. So if we come down here to blue, if we go this way, we'll get more blue. If we go this way, we'll get yellow. Let me bring this up a little bit. And you can see that's put a really strong cast on there. It's not one that I would want myself, but it depends upon what you're trying to do. If you've got a need to kind of accentuate colors, or maybe you're looking for something a bit more artistic than just a standard portrait, that gives you an option. You can go ahead and pull a little bit back to the blues, and it gives you a bit more of a faded, kind of muted color. What it doesn't do, though, is necessarily separate from your highlights with her skin tones and the shadows, like with this background that we've got. But you can tell from the overall change, I'd say that it's made an improvement for color correcting the photo. I would recommend, if you're using this, to make very small moves You might want to make a big move just to see what the change does. If you're not entirely sure, like we're on the green channel, say, well, what happens if I move red? Go ahead, pull it all the way over, see what color cast it puts in there. And then if you don't like it, which in this case, wouldn't blame you, you can go ahead and put it right back where you found it. And then maybe make a small adjustment. And then you can kind of see what happens from there. The next one I want to look at is color balance. This is one of the easiest ones to work with because you can see the colors right here, and you can also see your shadows, midtones, and highlights. So for this one, the shadows, we're going to be looking at this background up here. I kind of want to use the common thing of cooling that down, maybe not quite that much. And I don't know if I want to add any cyan to that or not, but I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to jump to the highlights next. And I want to bring her skin kind of got a bluish cast there, so I want to go ahead and warm her up a little bit. Might add some red to that as well. Now let's go to the midtone. I'm going to do just slightly a little bit with the same thing, a little bit there and here. And we've made a dramatic change. We've added a lot of contrast. This is one of the times where I told you think about changing your blend mode, because as you can see, not only is it changing the color, but it's also changing the contrast. If you go ahead and change your blend mode to color, then you're only affecting the color. The image looks a bit flat, but then you can go back and affect this with your contrast. As you can see, we're working the color mode and the image has gotten a bit flat. If you want to add some contrast to it, keep in mind that everything that you're working on here is inside of this same layer blend mode. So you want to add another layer and you want to add a new adjustment layer. And we're going to go ahead to brightness contrast. That one's going to be on normal. And then you can go ahead and adjust your contrast. Maybe add some brightness to it. And you can see on this layer, you're in normal. On this layer, you're in color. So there's the difference of what you're looking at. Let me go ahead and remove this layer. And I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the color balance. All right, let's move on to the next one. And this one's going to be looking at curves. Curves is a very popular, very old style kind of adjustment layer. It still has a lot of use today. I'm going to make sure my blend mode is in color, because let me go back and change this to normal. And let's say we'll select the blue channel. I just make a quick adjustment. You can tell that not only have we changed the color on it, but we've also changed the contrast. So let's change this back to color. I'm going to reset this. The idea here is pretty simple. You've got your RGB, which really is going to be affecting your contrast. What I want to do is I want to come over to a channel that we want to work with. Remember, blue, the opposite of that is going to be yellow. So if you want to know which way you're going, just grab a point here. You can see the dark ends that are meeting. Those are going to be your shadows. Up here, we've got the light ends. Those are going to be your highlights. Okay, pull this over this way a little bit. You can see we're moving towards the darkness. We're adding blue into the highlights. Same thing, if we go over here and we pull down a little bit, you'll see that we're going to be adding yellow. So let's start over here. Let's say that we want to take this point right here and just bring this up a little bit. And we're adding a little bit of coolness in the background. That's good for the background, but it's not so good for her face. You can see that we've lost a bit of color there. Overall, I don't mind it. If you're looking for kind of a cooler tone to the overall picture, that simple adjustment, you know, very small, could be just what you need. But if we want to bring her out a little bit more, let's go over to the red, and I'm going to bring this one over just a tad, and we've kind of warmed her up. You can see the before and after. We've still got our cool background, and we've got some nice color in her face and in her hair. As a matter of fact, if you look at the before, let me go ahead and get this. This is our after those two little adjustments we've made, and this is before. It almost looks like there's a bit of a green color cast on her now, doesn't it? So look at your curves, remember your opposites, red and cyan, green and magenta, blue and yellow. And as you can see, it takes very, very small adjustments to make a really enormous difference. All right, let's go ahead and move on down the line. The next one that we want to take a look at is going to be split toning. I also want to come back here to split color warmth. But for right now, I want to look at split toning. Let me turn this one off for a minute. The idea over here is you're once again separating your highlights and your shadows. What I would like to do is take my saturation. I'm going to turn it all the way up just for the highlights. And you think about what you want for your highlights. That's, to me, that's going to be her skin tone. And we're not going to leave it at 100%, but what you're doing is you're kind of going over and looking at what is the right color for her skin tone. And you can see how quickly we get from red, orange, through yellow, and into green. If you're getting into green, that's going to give her kind of a sickly color. So I want to come back to something that's kind of between red and orange. And I'm going to pull this down. And now I'm going to do the same thing with the shadows in this background area over here. And that, I'm once again going for kind of a cooler color. Might help if I turn my saturation all the way up. I'm going for a cooler color because I kind of want to get some contrast between the warmth of her skin and the background. And I think probably right about there and looking for something kind of cyan. All right, so you've got your selections of the colors that you want. Now the trick is, how much saturation do you put in each one? So I'm starting off very slowly. And also you have a balance down here between the two. What I think I'm going to do is I'm going to just push the saturation up until I see the background. And this is where the split screen really comes in handy. You can kind of see where the background is and also your foreground. But I'm looking at the background over here and I'm quite happy with that. Now I want to kind of push up the saturation on my highlights a little bit until I get her into a kind of a comfortable looking skin tone. The thing with the split toning though is you're not necessarily trying to do color correction. What you're doing here is going to be a bit more artistic. And you're trying to set a mood, and it could be something kind of a bit more funky than you would normally go for. So she's looking really yellow over here. And let's bring it, make a change for the balance. I kind of want to bring this back towards the cooler side. Let's look at our before and after. So this is where we're at now. This is where we were before. When you get into color grading and you think about some of the scenes that you've done, this one's kind of a happy scene, and yet I've made it look a little bit more like a something depressing and something, you know, out of a kind of a dramatic flick. Why don't we go ahead and change this up around and just basically do the opposite. Let's want to bring some warmth to my background. And let's pull the saturation back down out of her. The other thing you got to keep in mind is you don't necessarily need to change both of these. It is perfectly acceptable when you're split toning just to change the highlights or just to change the shadows. If you're not happy with the look that you're getting, maybe all you want to do is impact the shadows. I could do that. I could bring this down a little bit and maybe bring a little saturation up. And then you've got a look that is kind of unique to yourself. It's really, you're trying to affect a mood here rather than represent something perfectly color correct. All right, let me go ahead and get rid of this. And the last one I want to show you is going to be a split warmth color. I'm going to go with a different image for that one. Let's open up something of kind of a bit of a beach scene. And, you know, right off the bat, it is kind of flat. You don't see much separation between the sky and the water and the people. But that is where I really like this filter. And this one I've found, I don't really like using this one on portraits, but I think it does a really good job when you've got a, you know, a sky and a foreground. So it's called split color warmth. And as you can see, you've really got a choice between your warm colors and your cooler colors. So if you want to slide this all the way over here and this all the way over there, you can take a look and see. Suddenly it's bringing your warm colors up and your cool colors down. And just like that, you kind of change the scene dramatically. Let me go ahead and bring up the split. You can see, particularly here with the skin tones, if you're looking for that kind of cyan and teal look against the orange, this is a great one to do it. So your cool colors are looking much more enhanced and ready. It was really dull over here with the original image. And you kind of brought up, there was a very, honestly, it was a very boring sunset. But you can see the skies coming down. You've got your sunset over here. But what I really like are the skin tones against the water. And you can take these two extremes. Let's just see how bad we can make it. And it's adding a bit of darkness. If we go over here to blend mode, let's say we change that back down to color only. then we're not affecting the contrast. You can see the difference if I change from color back to normal. Oh, suddenly we're darkening the image. So like I said, some of these you may want to go ahead and change just to color so you're not impacting your contrast. You might want to do that on add a separate layer and then go ahead and affect your contrast to taste rather than letting one of these do it. That's a bit more than what I really want. Maybe actually the warmth I kind of like, but the cool colors balance out nicely here for me. And so that's our before and that's our after. And it just makes a nice subtle change, but a pleasant one at that. Thank you for taking some time to take a look at some of the filters for color grading and color correction inside of Luminar. If you'd like to use these files that I've shown in this demonstration, they're going to be available at williambeem.com/luminar2. And I'll put that link down in the description below. Finally, if you enjoyed this, I'd appreciate it if you give the video a like or a thumbs up. And of course, if you'd subscribe, that would be really wonderful. We'll have more coming up in the future. See you next time.